Please welcome Mike Lyons.
Realistically, 3-4 sets a piece. So if I did 6 exercises of 4 sets a piece, you're looking at 24 sets. Anything 5 exercises, 3-4 sets is sufficient. You don't need to, all these young guys coming in here and saying they're doing like 10 exercises with 6 sets a piece and blah, 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 blah. I'm doing 8 sets of squats and 10 reps. Like, again, it's blending philosophies from other sports into this, but realistically, it's, in my mind, it's not needed. Like, you can get an intense workout and get your growth by just concentrating on your form, concentrating on the movement pattern that you're doing, concentrating on the stretch and the flex of each movement, and just having your mind in the game the entire time. Instead of, shit, I'm doing squats now, so I need to save a little bit for the next one. I'm gonna go to leg press, I'm gonna do 10 sets there. It's just, it's too much. It's too much to think about. 3 hours later, you're fucking still in here lifting. And I came in and did my complete workout, did my cardio, and I'm home fucking eating a meal with my kids and my wife. So, it doesn't make any sense. Like, yes, bodybuilding is a lifestyle and is something that I have adhered to over the half of my life, realistically. I'm 43 and been in it over 20, almost 20 years, 20-some, 21 years. So, but it's not my entire life. My entire life is my family, my kids, my wife. This is something that I enjoy, something that makes me happy at the end of the day. I enjoy lifting, I enjoy putting my body through intense workouts. I don't understand this whole here for 4 or 5 hours and then going home and not having a life afterwards. It's something I never did even when I was prepping. Like, yes, everything is weighed, measured, everything's choreographed, you're on a schedule. Realistically, you don't have a life outside your house, but when I got home, my thought process transitioned into my wife and my kids. I still got my meals on time, everything was on the clock. They understood that daddy was in prep, and daddy ate at different times, but I still could cook my kids meals, breakfast, lunch. On the weekends, I would like make them pancakes or Eggo waffles or, man, I don't know how many times I could tell you that I was in full prep mode for pro shows and making my son toaster strudels and getting icing all over my fingers, but dying to lick it off, but I never did. So you can be strict, but you gotta have a life. You gotta have some sort of thing to look forward to. So if you don't have someone to come with you with the goal, like a sibling, a brother, a girlfriend, a boyfriend, a sister, like somebody to kind of progress and be there with you, realistically, like, you're doing it for yourself, all by yourself. Like I said before, go to the fucking trophy store and buy yourself a $10 trophy and say, I'm the best. Go home, be happy with yourself, put a poster on the wall. Like, at the end of the day, I love being able to go home and spend time with my wife and my kids. And if I do something great in bodybuilding or in sports, I have someone to, like, celebrate that or celebrate what they've done in their day. Like, my kid did well on the test or an exam. Like, I celebrate what their success is. So showing my kids that you can work hard and be successful in whatever life throws at you is letting them kind of know that life is hard, but you still need to, you need to work for it, but you need to celebrate your successes with your loved ones. And I don't know, that's my kind of thought process on it. Have something to look forward to.